And now it's time to look at the plethora of accessories that comes with this figure. We might as well start with the hands, because you got the closed fist hands I got there. You got more of the holding hands, kind of like a rectangular shape. Then you got one that's for like the an angular holding hand, like you have it kind of slanted. You've got open palm hands, which are very nicely detailed. You got more kind of relaxed open hands. You got trigger finger hands with a pointing index finger for the guns. And you've also got a slightly more angled fingers compared to these hands. Very minor, but yeah, quite a few sets. You got like I think it's 6 sets of hands, something like that. And that, I mean, that's a lot. But now we get to the stuff that is even more. And I could be missing things. There are quite a few things that you wouldn't expect to be on a figure like this. So let's look at the chest first, because it's got some interesting thing here. Now, you got these white panels. They look cool, right? Let me zoom in on them, though. Because if you open the one, it pops up. I'm assuming these are like Vulcans, or maybe like grenade launchers, but they're on both sides. And then all you do is just close it. And it just pops open again. I love it. It's so simple. Another thing that pops open on the thighs, you've got this darker blue panel here, and if you open it, it pops up a handle, just a handle, because you have a pair of clear green blades, and now you got daggers, very strike or impulse. But although it's more like the blue frame, because it has them on the thighs, but it's inside the thighs, where the blue frame would have outside. But yeah, you can see the little holster there, it just compacts back into the thigh. It's so cool. So this one would work well with like these kind of hands that have the rectangular hole. And yeah, it is a little bit annoying. You have to get rid of the blade in order to put these in. I just don't see enough space. I don't even want to try it, because I don't want to break those clear blades. But there's just no space in that calf or that thigh to accept those. So yeah, very cool little hidden detail that they got in there. Now, other stuff yet. You get these gauntlets that have, like, I guess these are energy containers, I assume. And you got the little peg here that can peg onto the arm. It's very secure. Looks cool. A lot of nice table printing and paint. But you can pull off these, and now you've got like little remote weapons that have some articulation. Little grabby hands. And they do provide you with some adapter pieces. So you can slide the wire into the end here. And then this will go into the hole in the arm guard. And so now it looks like it's shooting out. I mean, you can do obviously a better job than that, but yeah. It's cool that you have that ability. It's similar to, I guess, the I'm thinking of the Blitz, I suppose. Or even the weapons from the Dreadnought that were on the hips that could shoot out on wires. Something like that. So those are what you get on the body, pretty much. But now we got, oh boy, we got the backpack. So let's just lay you down for a second so we can take a good look at this goddamn backpack. Look at this thing. It is a thing of beauty, just like the whole rest of the figure. I love the little clear blue they got on the ball jointed thrusters. It does have LEDs you can put in right here. Unfortunately, once again, I don't have the right size batteries. You got these, like, wings that you can pose. You got double joints for the cannons. Now, I think the peg holes are all the same, so you could, like, mix and match. You can put the cannons if you wanted to down here, or the wings up here. I think it'll work. I don't really want to try it, because these are very, very tight connections, and I am terrified of the pegs breaking if I mess with it too much. But it's a very simple connection to the body. They actually designed the back here There's little tabs on this little round piece. So you just pull it off very easily. And then we just shove it in his back. It locks very, very securely. I am, once again, scared of taking it apart. Because I don't want it to, break off in the back. Alright, so the cannons are pretty cool. Get them over the shoulder. Has enough joint that you can get around that. I mean, they're nicely painted. Check those out. Camo printings on them and everything. Even the back is nicely painted on the, right here. More of those, batteries, I guess. So yeah, it's cool they're over the shoulder. But, if you want, you can yank them out. And now, you can have a handheld weapon. So yeah, now you got a rifle. And each can do that. You can flip up that. That's what kind of connected it into the back piece. Now this is cool though, because now you can flip that cover down, and now it reminds me of the Victory 2 Assault. Or is it the Buster? The Victory 2 Buster, I think. Got the camera player. It has like the can on one side. I think it's like a sensor on the other or something, but this thing, that looks like a Hyper Mega cannon to me. Something you can see on the stomach of the Zazabi, like a spread gun maybe, or like the head of the Double Zeta. It has that shape. Or the stomach of the Strike Freedom. It has that, and it's nicely painted too. It's spring-loaded. But yeah, you have a nice cover on there. These things can come down, I think, to lock in place. Once you have the cannon, I'm not really sure what this does. I feel like it locks the cannon into place when you put it back in. Yeah, but now you have the gun, and you can get the trigger finger hand. Now these are pliable hands. They're not super hard, but they're also I'm worried about scratching any paint on the actual weapons that it holds, because you do have to kind of force them on. And swapping the hands is very simple. And there we have the gun in the hand and one on the shoulder. You got a cannon here. You got the flip out boobzookas. I don't know. And I believe the extra bits can be put underneath the stand, so you won't lose them. I'll have to double check that. Now, other things are these. I'm not really sure. I feel like they're like anchors or something. It reminds me of the hip weapons of original Beast Wars Megatron. When he transforms, he has these hip-mounted, anchor missiles. And it's kind of like that, but it's kind of like a circuit board, because these also take LEDs. Which I don't have the right size again. So I'm not sure if they're really supposed to come apart, but they do. And they would light up green, which would be very cool, but oh well. Got this little metal hinge. And these are, I guess you could peg them here too, because like I said, they all seem to have the same kind of porthole. But if I remember correctly, it's supposed to be on the shoulders in the picture, so we'll put it there. Well, I gotta say, those are very, very scary to put onto the shoulders. I was really afraid those pegs were gonna break. They're not in all the way, because I really don't want to force it, but they're there. Kinda scary. And we also have a pair of swords on this cool little contraption with multiple hinges, which have a lot of metal pieces in them. And you got the sheaths there, which are nice, also nicely painted, and you got the cool swords, which would work with, I guess these hands would work pretty well, I would assume. Once again, I am very scared about getting these hands wrapped around and wrecking the paint. Alright, I managed to do it, somehow. So, pop that hand off. There we go. Alright, that was pretty nice with the sword in the hand. And to mount this thing on the back, you've actually got two options. Now the first option is this little gunmetal piece, which also has little grooves you can get your fingernails into. And you can just peg it in right there if you choose. But what I'm going to do is take this little panel and flip it down. Reveal the hole, and we'll put this back in here, just to keep track of everything. And you can peg it into the backpack itself. And I can have it stored there. Which I think was pretty good. It reminds me of something from Seed. I'm trying to think of what. Maybe the Calamity. But that doesn't have Sword. Sword Calamity? Sword Impulse? I guess. But there's other stuff you can do. If you take off the sheaths with the swords. Oh, now I gotta fight with your hand, get the sword out. Oh boy. Oh, okay. Easier to do once you get it in the first time, I guess. I loosened it up. Loosened up the hole. So you're gonna keep the two swords in the sheaths. And you're gonna peg them together. And then bring in this handle. And connect it. And now you have a Buster Sword. Which does look pretty good. I'm not sure what you can do with a handle when it's not as a Buster Sword. I have no idea. Now, there's also some ways you can mount this. First, you can store it on the back with this adapter. And so, in order that, you would have to remove the backpack itself and peg it right in. And for that, you have this little bracket, which I think the other one I have had the same thing. But yeah, it just clips in, it can rotate, and you just shove it in the back. And there is storage. So you can have it sideways if you want, straight back. And another thing I did forget, you can take these for the individual swords, and you could, if you want, peg them onto the side skirt, because there's the same port there. Like I said, there's probably a lot of things I don't know about that I missed, because there is a lot going on in this figure. Now let's see if I can get him holding this Buster Sword. Alright, so I tried the one with the less exaggerated index finger, so hopefully that'll work. I mean, it's holding right now. And yeah, it holds. Yeah, it's a little heavy, but I mean, it still holds it. So that is cool. And the last thing I do want to mention, these little things here, which you can move these parts out. Basically, if you want to have this on the stand with the magnet, you can have it there, and you can have it displayed with the swords. So these would be for the little sword separately, and then this would be for the middle of the big sword. You get two of those. So you can have this on the stand if you don't want to have the sword on the figure. You can have it in front or beside or whatever. It's just like a little sword stand. And that is it, I think. Like, there is so much to go over. I'm pretty sure I covered it all. So, it is an expensive figure. $200 about. You know, give or take. But, yeah, it's worth it if you ask me. For what you get, the quality of it, the figure, like, the metal in it, the superb paint job, all the LEDs you can put in if you have the batteries, all the weapons that can be used in different ways. It is great. It is a great, beautiful figure. And if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Shosie's store. And I'll see you in the next review.